to the Kent Lap Podcast.
What is the difference between physical therapy and chiropractic care? Maybe actually the better way to put that is, if someone's dealing with an issue, how should they know whether they should go to a physical therapist or a chiropractor?
So that's a great question. And I don't know the best way to answer that. I know what I do, the thought process that I use, is we have similar ideas because we want the body to be aligned and we want the body to move with certain mechanics and everything like that. I don't do adjustments. I don't do that. I will do mobilizations where we're gently like moving the, you know, the joints and things like that, but I don't actually adjust people. What I do is basically, that's what I tell people. I connect the brain back to the body with movement. Mm. That's what I do. Mm-hmm. In essence, sometimes that requires me to use manual means to get there to where they can actually do that. Mm-hmm. But yeah, that's definitely, more or less what I do.
Okay, so you're not going to, you know, crack people's back and their neck and stuff like that. However, if someone comes, it would be reasonable to think someone's going to come to you for some physical therapy because of, let's just say, lower back pain, right? That happens.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Okay. Some people might go to a chiropractor for lower back pain, but if they're coming to you, you might do some massaging and you might try to move this, loosen the spine or something. You're just not going to like adjust it like a chiropractor would.
Not really. No, I mean, I'm trained in what we call high velocity, low amplitude thrust techniques. I am trained in that. I very rarely do any of that stuff.
Okay.
It's just, I don't have as much experience in it, so I don't gravitate towards it. I gravitate towards what I know, which is I know how to move people.
Sure.
I know how to move people really well.
Mm-hmm.
And so what works really well for me is taking people through a process to where we can calm down the tissue, whatever it is. You know, if it's a muscle, if it's, you know, a joint that's not moving properly, calm it down, make it where it doesn't hurt as much, mm-hmm. and then start putting them through the process of loading it so we get rid of pain. And I use different techniques. I use dry needling, which is the acupuncture needle where we stick it in the muscle.
Mm-hmm.
Then we can either do pistoning, which is pushing the needle in and out on it, or we can hook it up to an eSTEM unit. So you actually have intramuscular stimulation.
Okay.
So,
and is the thought process there, if you loosen the muscles and get the muscles how they need to be, the bones will then fall into place, or the spine will then fall into place?
So not necessarily loosen. It depends on what the body needs, right? So everything's based on assessment. If it's a tight muscle that needs to loosen, yes. Sometimes tightness, though, is actually the brain's response to, I need something to change. This muscle is actually weak, so I'm going to make it feel tight. And I can't tell you how many times I've taken people like that have tight hamstrings, put them through deadlifts, and you know, you're going to stretch a little bit when you do deadlifts, but I'll take them and, you know, we'll work on strengthening, like eccentric, not always eccentric, but some strengthening on hamstrings, and then magically they can touch their toes.
Mm.
All because the brain was like, oh, that's what I wanted.
I
wanted some pressure put on that thing.
Yeah. Okay.
And that's what it's asking for.
So I know this is one of the great things that I like about CrossFit is the group dynamic and having people there. And I like to go to the 11:30 class. It's one of the bigger classes at CrossFit Forte where I go. And of course, you know, there's people of all different stripes and types and opinions and those types of things. And I know there's at least one guy there who, you know, would think there is something valid to physical therapy, but he thinks chiropractic care is like, it's like, I don't know. I don't know if he thinks it's a scam or what. So like, what would you say to that then? Like, why would he think? And because I know there's...